Hello friends, welcome to this video on CAT 2019 solutions. In this video, we'll solve CAT 2019 slot 2 BI questions. So we'll solve two sets in this particular video, and other two sets we'll solve in the second part. So let's start with the first set. So this was the set which was given in the exam. Okay, so we are given that there are 10 players, okay, and they are participating in a tournament. Okay, wait a second, I'll just enlarge it so I guess we can see it better. Okay, so there are 10 players listed in the table. Okay, they participated in a rifle shooting competition comprising of 10 rounds. Each round had 6 players. Player number 1 to 6 participated in round 1. Okay. 2 to 7 in round 2. Then 5 to 10 in round 5. Then 6 to 10 in round 6. 7 to 10 and 1 and 2 in round 7 and so on. Okay. So it's a cyclic order. Okay. So 1 to 6, then 2 to 7, 3 to 8. Okay. And then once 5 to 10. Once they are over, okay, 6 to 10 plus 1. So that's how it's cycled, okay, which was looking. There were no ties in any of the 10 rounds. Okay, sorry. The top 3 performances in each round were awarded 7, 3, and 1 point respectively. Okay, there were no ties in any of the rounds. The table gives the total number of points obtained by 10 players after round 6 and round 10. Okay. But first of all, what we can do is we can determine the rounds in which players played. Okay, so if you see, player number 1 played in round 1, then the player was not there till round, if you see, 6. Okay, round 1 it was there, then in round 6 we'll have 6 to 10 plus 1. Then from 6 onwards, player number 1 was there. Okay, so I can write player number 1 is in round 1, then 1 6 to. Player number 2 was in round 1 and 2, then 7 to 10. Similarly, player number 3 was in round 1, 2, 3, and then 8 to 10. Player number 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, then 9 and 10. Player number 5, 1, 2, 5, and 10. Player number 6 was there from 1 to 6, then 2 to 7, 3 to 8. 4 to 9 and 5 to 10. So we know the rounds in which these players played. Okay. And good thing is they are named A, B, C, D, E, so which is easy to understand. Okay. So this is the first information we know. So from here, what we can say is after round 6, okay. So player number 1, Amita, played in only round number 1 and 6 only. Okay. So that is something which we can know. Okay. Now, second thing which we have to do is if you see, the top 3 performance in each round were 7, 3 and 1 points respectively. Okay. So, if you see, Amita played number 1, played in only 2 rounds and her score is 7. That means, this is 7 plus 1. There is no other way we can get 8. 7 plus 7, 3 and 1 are the options available. Okay. Bala, obviously it has to be 1 plus 1. Okay, now this player number 3, Chen, okay, he played in round 1, 2, 3 until round 6. Now, so he cannot have 1 plus 1 plus 1, reason being Bala has played in only round 1 and 2 and he has scored 1 plus 1. That means he scored 1 and 1 in round 1 and 2, which we already know. Okay, so Chen means the player number 3 can have only 3, not 1. So, okay. David similarly can have 3 plus 3 because he played in 3 rounds only. Okay, 3 plus 1 plus 1 1 is not possible because Bala has got 1 1. Eric played from round 1 to 5. He can have 1 or 3, so we'll just come back to it later. Fatima played in 6 rounds and we have 10. Okay, so for 10 we can have 7 plus 3 or 7 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Okay. But 7 will definitely be there. Okay, 3 plus 3, then 4 1s can possible, but then that is not allowed because of the because of Bala. Okay, so I'll write 7 plus 3. Gordon played, we can easily write 7 plus 7 plus 3. Hansa, it is 1. Ikea, it's 1 plus 1. Joshin played in only 2 rounds till round 6, 5 and 6. So 7 and 7. That means these two rounds were won by player number 10. Okay. So we have once if you see 1, 2, 3, all 6 ones are gone. So that means Eric has scored 3 in the round in which he has scored something. Okay. Once we are done with it, okay. Let's see, we will come to this part later. Okay. So first of all, what we'll do is we'll try to determine scores in rounds, okay, round 1 to 10. Okay. So reason being, if you see in the question we are asked, questions are what were scores, okay, of Chen, David and Eric after round 3, okay, and then which was the player in the last 3 positions in round 4. So we need to have exact scores, okay, so that is why we have to find the scores, okay, there's no other way around. So I'm just drawing the lines, okay, table. Since you have to do it in the exam also, so let's practice it fast, okay, right? We have to do it for round all 10 rounds, so I'm just drawing extra lines also, okay, apart from till round 1 to 6, okay. So this is round 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so these are extra lines, okay, you can erase, okay. Now I'll use a black ink so that we can mark them easily, okay, in the right background. Okay, so let's come to round 1 to 6. Amita has scored 7 and 1. Okay, now the first thing which we can start with is I think Joshin scored 7 in round 5 and 6, so I'll write 7 and 7. Did not play in any of the other rounds, okay, so we can mark clock crosses. You can mark. So it's 4, 3, 2, and 1. Sorry. Okay. Here it will be round number 2, 3, 4. Okay. And then these 4, and these 3, and these 2, and this 1. Okay. Player number 6 played in 1 to 6, all the rounds in the first 6 rounds. Okay. Now, since Joshin scored 7 in round 6, so Amita cannot score 7, so that means Amita scored 1. That means Amita scored 7 in round 1. So we are done with these two players, okay. We know their scores, okay. Bala scored 1-1 in first 2 rounds, only 2 rounds he played. Chen scored 3 in first 3 rounds, so it can be 1, 2 or 3, any place, okay. So we are holding on to it, we'll come back to it later. David 3 plus 3, anything is possible. Eric, anything is possible. Okay, now we need extra information which is given in here. Gordon did not score consecutively in any 2 rounds. Gordon, if you see, played from 2 to 7, means 2 to 6. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5 rounds. Okay, and he did not score in consecutive rounds, means 7, 7, 3. So he scored in round 2, then 0. Then scored in round 4 and then 0. Now he has scored 7-7-3, so definitely he did not score in round 6, 7 in round 6, because 7 is already there by Joshin. So this is 3, 7, and this is 7. So Gordon is also done. We can complete values in round 6, okay, so that we will not get confused, okay. So that is okay. So we have 7 in round 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. Fatima's score in round 3 has to be 7. That is the only place which is left. Okay. Now, point number 2 is Eric and Fatima both scored in a round. Eric scored 3 and Fatima scored 7 and 3. So they cannot score 3-3 together. So the round in which Fatima scored 7, that is the round in which Eric scored 3. So that means you can write 3 here. Okay. So that is what we can do. So Eric is also done. Now we'll come to Hansa, IKEA. Okay, they have scored 1 and 2. Okay, so if you see, IKEA has scored 1-1 in round 4, 5, 6. 5, 6 is already won by Amita. So IKEA scored 1-1 here. That is, these are the only two places. Okay, that means Hansa cannot score 1-1 in round 4 and 5. That means Hansa scored, the only place Hansa can score 1 is round 3. So we can write 0-0 here. That is also done. So we know scores of all these players. We are left with Chen, David, Fatima. Okay. Now Fatima scored from 1 to 6. Okay, so these are scores by Fatima. Okay. Now in, let's see round 5. Round 5, Eric has scored 3. His score is done. So we can write 0-0 all the places. Round 5, only place person left is Fatima, so we have to write 3 here. That is the only person who can score. So Fatima's numbers also be okay. Now come to Chen and David, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you have to find they have together, they have scored in round number 1, 2, and 4. Round number 4, the only possibility is David can score 3. Okay, so that is also done. Okay, round 3, we already know all the entries. Okay. Now round 1 and 2, Chen can score, player number 3 can score here or in the second round. Similarly, David can score, so we don't know here. So I'll add 0,3, 0,3, 0,3. So this is something which we don't know. Okay, you can keep this part. Okay, so this is something which is not known. I'm just circling it so that we will come back to it later, or we'll just remember it. Okay, now so round 1 to 6 is over. Okay, so here this is very important. When we are given sum, we have to split the values and we have to assign values, okay, according to the conditions given. Now let's move to next, round number 6, 7 to 10. 7 to 10, Amita scored additional 10, so that means that sum has to be 7-3 or 7-1-1. Okay, so let's wait till here. Okay, Bala scored 5, so 3. I'm just writing additional score. Okay, we'll write the total summation later. Okay, so that is 3 chain. Okay, this is 0, 7, 0, 0, 3, 15, and 3. Okay. So that is all we know. Okay, now there are certain information written. Okay, so we'll read to that information first. Only two players scored in 3 consecutive rounds. One of them is Chen. Okay, Chen is player number 3 and scored just 3 in these 4 rounds. So that is 111. That is the only way he this person can score in all 3 rounds. Means 3 consecutive rounds. Okay, so 111. So you see, out of 4 rounds, 3 ones are taken by Chen. Okay, so there's only one left. Okay. We can simply write 7,3 here as well, because there's no chance of having ones. Okay. Now 1-7, we need 4 sevens as well. Okay, so 1-7 here, then Eric can score, and then IKEA can score. So I can write, just directly write 7 plus 7 plus 1 and 7. So all the sevens are over, all the ones are over. So I'm just writing 3s. Okay, these are the 3s which are left. So we know who the scores. Okay, now we have to assign them to round 7 to 9. So we know what are scores scored by them. Okay, let's go there. Okay, we can eliminate. Okay, we can directly cross what are the worst values, means players who did not play in any of these rounds. Okay, so Mr. Player number 3 played only 8, 9, 10. So I'm just crossing here. 4 consecutive rounds were not played. Okay, so we can just slide it away. Player number 6 did not play at all. Okay. Player number 7, these 3 crosses, player number 2, and this. Okay. So this is how we can do it. Okay. So these values, they are not played, participated at all. Okay. 0-0s, we can write the entries as well. So 0-0-0. Okay. So this is also 0. So we have done a good amount of work. Okay. Now player number 3 scored 111 and he has has played in only 3 rounds, so I'll write triple one. This is done. Player number, if you see, 9 has scored 7-7-1, played in 3 rounds only, so I can write, we cannot write 7-7-1 because 1-1 is here, so this has to be 1. These two are 7-7. So we know his values as well, okay? So that is also done. Then we are given that Joshin scored in round 7. Joshin scored just 3 and in round 7, so we can write 3 here. So remaining scores by Joshin are 0-0. Okay, so that is also done. Okay. Amita scored in round 10. Amita scored 7 and 3. Okay, so if you see, these are the values we have. Okay, 1-3 is here. Okay, so okay. So we have to think where we can put 7. Okay, so we'll come back to it later. Okay, Eric scored 7. Eric, wait a second, I just written 7. My mistake, I should have written 7 here. So Eric scored 7 here. Amita scored in round 10. Okay, so Amita has won round 7. That is the only way we can put 7. And we have to put 3 because Amita has scored in round 10 as well. This is what given to us. So I can write 0 here. Okay, 3 threes are over. Okay. Now, coming to Hansa, Hansa scored 3. Cannot score in round 7 because Joshin has scored, so we add 0 and 3. Now we are left with only 3, which is by Bala, which has to be in round 9. So we know all these values. So we're done with everything. Okay. Only part which we don't know is Chain and David's part of it. Now let's start solving these questions again. What are the scores by Chain, David, and Eric respectively after round 3? So after round 3, out of these two, 0, 3 will be there. So sum of player number 3, Chen, will be 3. Okay. So all these options are applicable. David, one of these is 3. Round 3, David scores 0. So 3, 3. When we are looking for 3, 3. So these two options can be eliminated. Okay. Now coming to round, Eric scored just 3 in round 3. Okay. So it has to be 3-3-3, triple 3, that is our answer. Okay, so let's solve question number 2. Which of the 3 players were in the last 3 positions after round 4? So if you see, Joshin did not play at all. So one of them is, so I'll write 0 here. Okay, there is score. Ikea scored just 1. Hansa 1. Then Gordon was among the toppers, okay. Fatima 7, Eric 3, one among David, and means these they have scored 0-3-0 or 0-0-3, so 3. They have scored also 3, Bala 2 and Amita 3. So among the bottom 3 are Bala, Hansa, Ikea and Joshin. Okay, so we are asked, so these 3 players, bottom players, Joshin, Ikea and Hansa. Joshin, Ikea and Hansa, okay, Joshin, Ikea and Hansa are given option 4. Which player scored max points in maximum number of rounds? So we'll just count. Okay. So if you see, Amita scored in 1, 2, 3, 4 rounds. Ikea scored in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rounds. Okay. Chain scored in 1, 2, 3 rounds. Just 3 rounds. Sorry. Chain scored in 1, 2, 3, 3 rounds. Okay. Then 4 rounds. My mistake. Joshin scored in 3 rounds. So answer of this is IK. Then players scored points in last round are 7. Okay, if you see Amita, Chain and Eric. Amita, Chain and Eric. So option number 2. Okay, so this was I would say very time consuming set because you had to process information till round 6 and then 7 to 10. And you have to find individual information, otherwise you could not have solved the question. That is the one way to approach this question. Other way could have been, we could have directly focused on the point means questions itself. Okay, but then if you see for question number 2 and let's means 3 and 1, we had to find exact numbers. Okay, so question number 3 we could have answered using the information which we have written in the in the table, this thing 7 plus 1 and all these things. Okay, but for question number let's say for something like 2, we had to exactly identify when these scores were scored, because it is round 4. We are asked about round 4. We don't know what it means. So we have to find who scored in round 5 and 6. Okay. So that is why this was a very lengthy question. Now we'll solve one easy question from the same paper. Okay. So that will give us, okay. Again, DI question. Okay. So in this question, we are given 3 pouches are kept in each of the 3 9 slots in 3 by 3 grids. Okay. Which is given as in the figure. Okay. As shown in the figure, each pouch has a certain number of 1 rupee coins. The minimum and maximum number of money among the 3 pouches in each of the 9 slots are given in the table. So, row number 1, column 1, we have minimum number 2, maximum number 4. Okay. For example, we know that among the 3 pouches kept in second column, first row. Second column, first row, which is here. Okay. And these numbers are given. That minimum amount is 6 and maximum becomes 6. So among these 4 or 3, minimum 6, maximum is 8. So the middle one can be 6 or 7 or 8. Okay. There are 9 pouches in any of the 3 columns as well as any of the 3 rows. So 9 column wise, 9 row wise. It is known that the average amount, this is very important everyone, average amount of money kept in 9 pouches in any row or any column is an integer. So that means if you add this way or this way, all these numbers are multiple of 9. It is known that the total amount of money kept in 3 pouches in the first column of third row is 4. Okay, so first column and third row, this total is 4. So we have quite much information. So we have to find exactly the numbers. Okay, so if you see, 9 numbers are not given, middle values. Okay, and we have to find those values. Okay, so I'll just make an extended matrix with this information, okay, about all the parts. Okay, so just making the matrix everyone. So that's right. I'm going to write all the numbers. Okay, so we know 2, then we have 4. The middle value is not known. Then we have 6, then we have 8. We have 1, this missing number, and 3. We have 3, missing number, and 5. We have 1, maximum 1, that means middle value is also 1. Okay, so one of the variables we are directly know, 6, middle value, and 20. This sum is 4 and we are given 1 plus 1, 1 and 2. That means the middle value is 1. This is 1, the space, and 2. And then we have 2, middle value, and 5. So if you see, we have to find these 7 variables. Okay. Now one, the important piece of information is row wise or column wise, the sum is a multiple of 9. So if you see, we see this column, the column 1 first, reason being, all means only 2 values are unknown here. So we add everything, 2 plus 4 6, 6 plus 8 is 6 plus 8 is 14, plus 4 is 18. So 18, okay, we don't know this value and this value, okay, so these two are not known. And this sum should be multiple of 9, and these values should be, this value cannot be more than 4, okay, this value cannot be more than 5. 18 is already there, sum is multiple of 9. The only possibility, next number which is multiple of 9 is 27. The sum cannot be 36, otherwise we need 18. Sum of these two has to be less than 9. So only way that can happen is sum of these two is 9. And the values which we'll get is 4, 5. So this is 4, this is 5. So we know these two values. Sum has to be multiple of 9, sum we already have is 18, we need x sum to be multiple of 9, so that is sum can be 27 only, so we need 9 extra, so that can be 4 and 5 only. 3, 6 is not possible, otherwise this will exceed. Okay, the limit we have is this value cannot be, has to be between 2 to 4, and this value has to be between 3 to 5 including the extremities. Okay, with this, okay, what we can do is we can use this one, reason being we know all everything except this one. So means this second row, if you add everything, okay, what you will get is 13, then 16, then 36, 42. 42 plus missing leg. Okay, and that has to be multiple of 9. It has to be more than 6. So next number more than 6, okay, so we can say 42, then we have 45. 45, we need just 3, which is not possible. 54, 54 will need 12. Okay, that is possible. Then next number is we need 63. 63, we need 21, which is not possible. So this has to be 12. Okay, let's go for column 2 now. We see some 8, 14, 17, 18, and 20. So we have sum is equal to 20. And we are given that, okay, the sum has to be multiple of 9. So next sum has to be 27. So sum of these two is 7. Now that can be 6 comma 1. Okay. And is there anything other way possible? No. So there has to be 6 comma. Once we have done that, then easily we can find what means row number 1 and row 3 as well. Row number 1, 10 plus 20, 30, 30 plus 34, 30 plus 4, so we need 36, I'll adjust 2. We add horizontally 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 15, so this has to be 3. So we know values, all the values. Okay, what is the total number of money in the three pouches kept in first row? First column of second row. First column of second row. Second row, so that is 30. How many pouches contain exactly one column? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. Okay. Then, what is the number of slot for which the average amount in of three pouches is an integer? Okay. What is the number of slot for which average amount in rupees for three pouches is an integer? Okay, so this 10 by 3 not an integer, 20 by 3 not an integer, 6 by 3 that is an integer. So I'll just write tick, 30 not an integer, tick, 3. If we add all these, you'll get 38 not an integer, 4 not an integer, not an integer, not an integer. So it's just 2. The number of slots for which the total number of its three pouches strictly exceed 10. So this is not exceeding 1, 2, 3, 3 pouches. So this was an easy set. We had to just find the middle value. We had to just keep this condition in mind. So you have to just use the table of 9 and you have to find what is the additional amount we need. And you have to split to get the correct answer. So I hope you understood the concept. Thank you very much.